Chapter 2, A Sweet Proposal.
Is this over yet?
Cranky growled, ripping the crown off his prickly head.
Ow.
He was, after all, called Cranky for a reason.
I have things to do. I can't just hang around all day, you know?
Of course, champ,
Applejack smirked. She patted him on the back. Great job today. He grunted and looked at her hoof, as if he couldn't believe she touched him. Matilda, the lady love, walked up to greet him.
You won! I'm so proud, she said with a smile.
Applejack noticed a slight blush on Frankie's face.
Read enough already with the compliments. I just ate some pie,
he grumbled.
But you did it! Super awesome-rifically!
Pinky called out as she bounded over. She was still wearing her bib. She didn't look at all upset that she'd lost.
You should be proud of yourself, too!
Way to go, Cranky, said Twilight Sparkle as she, Rarity, Fluttershy, and Rainbow Dash joined them. Applejack could sense how uncomfortable Cranky was getting.
All right, y'all. Give the champion his space.
She motioned for the ponies to step back. Cranky and Matilda nodded gratefully. As the two donkeys turned toward home, Applejack thought about how a pony never really knows what to expect from others.
They sure could surprise you.
Applejack had learned an important lesson today.
Already?
And she didn't want to forget it.
Hey, Twilight,
Applejack said.
Who has our journal? I haven't written an entry in a long time, but I think I got something to say about Cranky.
Uh-oh.
Wow, and I'm...
I just read that book before this one. The Journal of Friendship. Recently, the six ponies had been so tied up with other activities that they hadn't been writing in the journal they shared. Originally, they modeled it after the journal of the two sisters that Princess Celestia and Princess Luna shared. But now it had become so much more than that to the friends. It was high time that one of them paid a little attention, and that pony was going to be Applejack.
Great idea,
Twilight grinned. She was always trying to get the others to participate in recording their lessons. It was valuable information.
Oh, I have to get back to the boutique, darling, said Berry. I suppose the last thing I read about was my apprentice, Charity Sweetmint.
Woo-wee! My pony sure was a hoofful,
Applejack nodded, recalling how the young fashionista had tried to become just like Rarity.
But you sure meant well, of course.
Of course you did,
Rarity nodded, and her perfectly coiffed purple mane swayed gently.
And you'll all be thrilled to hear that she's doing fabulous with her own line in Manhattan. She's been featured as a designer to watch in Pegasus Weekly.
Pegasus Weekly. Oh, the puns. Oh, they're beautiful.
Well, that's great news. So I'll come on by and grab the journal now, if that's all right with you, Rarity,
Applejack said.
Just gotta clean up this mess, and I'll be right over.
I'll help,
Pinkie Pie squeaked.
By taking some of those scrum-diddly-up-just leftover pies off your hooves,
she patted her already bulging tummy. How she could eat any more pies after the contest was beyond Applejack. As Granny Smiths would say, Pinkie Pie must have a hollow hoof, where she was hiding all that food.
I think some pony already beat you to it, Applejack said.
She pointed to the table. Apple Bloom and Sweetie Belle were already helping by chowing down and making it an even bigger mess. The six ponies all chuckled at the little fillies.
Excuse me, ladies. I don't mean to interrupt,
said a beige-colored stallion with a light blue mane as he trotted up to the group. Is that Caramel? Maybe Caramel? Huh? Is Cutie Mark with a blue ribbon?
Never mind.
A quick series of looks exchanged among the friends made it clear that no pony recognized him.
But are you Applejack of Sweet Apple Acres?
He asked, raising an eyebrow.
Yep, that's me, Applejack tipped her hat. Who might you be, and what can I do for you?
My name is Blue Ribbon. I run the Best of Equestria Awards, said the stallion.
He passed Applejack a business card. Sure as the sun sets in the sky, it said, Blue Ribbon, Best of Equestria Rewards. Finding the best businesses in Equestria since the first summer sun celebration.
We've been around for a long time, then, true.
I'm here to tell you that Sweet Apple Acres has been named as a finalist in our Best Orchard in Equestria contest. Congratulations.
Really?
Well, that's a humdinger, Applejack exclaimed.
I mean, thank you kindly, Mr. Ribbon.
She looked to her friends, who had all started whispering excitedly to one another.
Is there anything I need to do for you?
Not too much, Blue Ribbon smiled.
He flipped open a folder filled with forms. He scanned the page with his hoof and jotted down some notes.
We'll come by the farm on Friday to check out the place. If the harvest numbers you've reported to the Equestria Farmer's Almanac are correct, you've got nothing to worry about.
That's some apple field. I've never seen anything like it in all my years.
Well, we do try our best over at Sweet Apple Acres. Applejack tried to recall the numbers they'd reported to the Almanac, but she couldn't for some reason. Maybe Granny Smith had submitted the paperwork this year. Surely it would all be just fine. Applejack tipped her hat at Blue Ribbon.
We'll be ready, sir.
I hope so,
Blue Ribbon said, putting his hoof on her shoulder.
The winner of the award will be named the official exclusive apple supplier for Canterlot Castle.
Ooh, nice.
How divine, Meredy gasped. Does it include VIP access to all the events? For Applejack and her friends?
To the Wonder Bowls Derby, said Rainbow Dash, because that's the only one I really care about.
Applejack shot her friends a look to shush them, but Rarity had a dreamy look in her eyes, and Rainbow Dash had already stopped paying attention.
There will be lots of perks, Blue Ribbon said. Front row seats, said the Equestria Rodeo, definitely. Tickets to the Hearthswarming Neve Annual Ball. Oh, and one grand prize that is sure to delight any farm pony.
That all sounds real nice, Mr. Ribbon, Applejack replied. But we apples don't need any prizes.
What about a brand new plot of land to expand your farming empire?
Blue Ribbon smirked. Applejack's jaw dropped in surprise. Now that really was a prize worth winning. She tried to hide her elation.
See you on Friday, Applejack.
Blue Ribbon turned on his hoof and began to walk away. He looked over his shoulder and called out,
and as we say at Best of Equestria, best of luck.
If Applejack had anything to say about it, she wouldn't need a smidgen of luck. Just good old-fashioned work.
Hey, Applejack, said Twilight Sparkle. How about the five of us help you out with this apple buck season?